Hey, what's going on, everybody? Happy Thursday, is it now? We're absolutely crushing the week. We're crushing the new year. It's already the 7th. Obviously, there's a bunch of tragedies going on. There was recently that huge problem where people were rushing into DC. I'm hopefully going to give you guys a break from all that political bullshit. Let's focus on some stuff that can actually improve ourselves. So maybe you're a grappler and you hear all this noise about the different fitness strategies that you're supposed to be doing in order to better yourself as a grappler. You might have heard of doing yoga or calisthenics, bodyweight exercises, kettlebells, strength training. There's a lot of different ways to slice and dice it. But here, let me stop you there. No matter what you wind up doing, there's going to be three common mistakes that most grapplers are doing when they start to involve some fitness training. So I'm going to go over these three mistakes in this video, but attached to this, you can grab my free cheat sheet video series to learn exactly what type of fitness strategy will work best for you as a grappler. So if you want that, just comment down a GIF and I'll send you over the video series. We're going to go over the common mistakes right now and then go over the solution in that video series. So comment down a GIF if you want that. But without further ado, let's get into the first common mistake in strength training, which is going to be too much effort. Now, how many people here are the all-in, all-out mentality? Who here loves to just go 100% balls to the wall and go hard as possible? I know that for me, I'm naturally a very competitive person, and I love to go hard. I love to train hard. I love training. I love doing things to the extreme. It's just something that I like to do. And there's a lot of people out there like yourself that might be one of those people that likes to just put 110% into everything that they do. And that's awesome. That's going to take you farther than most people. Now, the problem is when you start involving strength training in your jiu-jitsu or MMA or grappling training, you have to make sure that you're not doing too much. So the number one common mistake is that there's too much effort in your strength training. So maybe you've talked to people who are really big into fitness. Maybe they're in great shape. Maybe they do, you know, bodybuilding, and you might want to take advice from them. Or maybe you were really big into fitness in the past, and then you got into jiu-jitsu and you want to start following that same routine that's very similar to what you did in the past or what you might have learned from one of your friends that was really big into fitness. The problem is that maybe that past routine or the routine that your friend that's really big into fitness is doing, it doesn't actually equate to productive training for your grappling. Most people that are into fitness are simply doing it to get in shape. Not that there's anything wrong with looking to get in shape or applying fitness strategies in order to get in shape. There's nothing wrong with that. We should all want to look our best, feel our best, and, you know, look attractive to the opposite sex. Of course, that's great. But when you are doing jiu-jitsu 2, 3, 4, 5 times a week, your strength training has to revolve around being able to recover for your jiu-jitsu training. So a lot of people will make the mistake of doing too much, and now all of a sudden, they're too fatigued for their strength, for their jiu-jitsu training or for their MMA training. So make sure that you don't put in too much effort. You are backpedaling a little bit when you need to. The number two most common mistake out there is people believe that they should do high reps and lots of cardio. Now, it's just not necessary. You know, there's going to be a lot of people out there that say, oh, well, you know, grappling or fighting, there's an endurance sport side to it. You want to be able to do things for long durations of time rather than doing short bursts of high intensity, which is usually involved in lower rep training, strength training, heavier lifts. But it's not necessary to do high reps and cardio because you're already, well, it's not that you shouldn't do cardio or that you shouldn't do high reps, but if you do it too much and you don't do enough of the low rep strength training, all you're going to do is wind up becoming too sore, and it's going to negatively affect your regular MMA or your regular jiu-jitsu or your regular grappling training. What you should really just prioritize is the gym is meant to help you get stronger and to improve your athletic performance. And then you have to train jiu-jitsu or striking or whatever, grappling, in order to be better at your sport. You're not going to get better at your sport with these random exercises that are meant to be sport specific to grappling. The actuality is get better at jiu-jitsu, get better at grappling, get better at MMA, and use the gym as a way for yourself to get stronger. Go into the gym, do some stuff that's good for your posture, hit some strength compound lifts, and get out. You stimulate muscle growth, you stimulate some strength growth, and then you dip out and you get ready for your jiu-jitsu training, right? That's how you should go about it, right? Not high reps and cardio, but focusing on that strength training. And if you want to throw in some cardio, go ahead and do it. And then the third common mistake in strength training for grapplers is going to be not training heavy and not training with barbells. So a lot of people in the grappling sphere like to focus on things like bodyweight exercises and kettlebells because it tends to be a lower risk, high reward type of training where people believe that it's very functional. It's good for your joints, you're able to move properly. You know, that stuff is great, but the problem is that it's very hard with body weight and kettlebells to really stimulate a lot of strength growth. I mean, if you're using a kettlebell, you know, a lot of people find like a 55 pound kettlebell for most kettlebell exercises to be pretty good as far as strength goes. But that same individual could potentially put 200 to 300 pounds on their back and squat it down and up. So now, of course, you might be questioning, well, doesn't that strength training just put yourself at higher risk for injury because there's more load? Well, if you don't know what you're doing and you're not being intentional, then yes, absolutely. But that can also happen with body weight and kettlebell exercises as well. I mean, how many people will do pull-ups in a way where they round their shoulders at the top rather than retracting their scapula back? You could still do body weight and kettlebell exercises incorrectly, but when you do barbell exercises under heavy load, when you do them correctly, you flare your knees out in the proper way, you brace your core in the proper way, your spine has proper alignment. When you are using heavier lifts, you're going to have a lot of benefits to that. There's going to be testosterone boosts, but there's also going to be an effect that strengthens your joints. Your joints are going to be a lot more durable if you're able to squat 250 pounds on a front squat, for instance, as long as you're doing it correctly. But of course, that goes for anything. And of course, we have to look at the fact that in jiu-jitsu, we're putting ourselves in these weird positions. We're getting our feet stacked to the floor. We're going inverted, right? We're in this rounded posture where our shoulders are rounded forward. Maybe we're bending over and putting weight onto our toes that can affect our knees. We're bending over, letting our background, there's all these weird postural imbalances, and the strength training will help reverse the negatives that come from those postural imbalances from things like jiu-jitsu. So yeah, those are the three most common mistakes. Maybe you're making one of those mistakes. If you are, that's okay, because now you're educating yourself further and you won't make the same mistake again. And remember, if you want, you can grab my free cheat sheet video series that will go over what you should be focusing on in your strength training so you don't make those mistakes. If you do want a copy of that video series, just comment down a GIF and I'll get that over to you ASAP. But overall, I'm gonna go and enjoy the rest of my day. We got training a little bit later tonight, got a little work to do. The weather's looking nice out here in Myrtle Beach, so I'm gonna try to get some sun in as well. If I can sneak it in, that'd be great. I hope everybody enjoys their day and is looking forward to the weekend. Take care, have a good one.